Okay, we're gonna do elements. I'm gonna remove the stuff that I used in the previous video, and I'll leave this one here just to keep it simple. The elements are in the same place as the effects on the top menu. There's elements, and there are even more elements than effects, almost 400. I must say I have a few added also in transitions and effects. You see some with a red dot. Those are things that I downloaded from the Filmora website. Free downloads, by the way, packages that you can download with certain themes like Marriage Travel. Nice stuff, and you can add it to Filmora for free, and you will see what the default ones are and what the downloaded ones are. But the effects, elements. What you see here, and I click all, if I start scrolling down here, you see emojis. And of course, you all know what they are, but these are not normal emojis. These are emojis that move. And for example, let's take this one. I drag it down to the timeline and you don't see it moving now, but the video is not playing. What I wanted to show you is that if you click in the preview, you see the outlines highlighted and you can just drag a corner to size, resize the emoji. Don't use the sides because you will screw up the ratio of the thing. Just use the corners, and it doesn't matter which corner, if you do top, bottom, left, right, and you can turn around, rotate the image as well. If I play the video, I'll drag the playhead just before the element appears, and I'll click play. That's what you see when you use an element. And again, there are a lot here, and a lot of different elements as well. If you want to make your own intro clips or whatever, let's say that I drag this one down. If I play this, I have a nice idea with Bon Appetit. It suits perfectly with France. You can't change those elements. That's something that's not possible. You have to make use of the things that Filmora provides you. So if they're not suitable for you, sorry, but there are a lot of nice things that you can use in your video. And there are things like this one that you can use and put your own titles, your text in there. I'll remove all these. And actually, in some of these videos, you see an arrow appear, and there's an extra category for tutorial, but I just scroll down here. Also, you can use this thing, a finger. It's a moving finger. If I would explain to you in the video that you should not click this or not do that, then you will see that hand moving to show you that you are not allowed to do that. You, like I said, with the tutorials, if I scroll down, you see arrows. I'll just click it. That's more effortless. Depending on the kind of background that you have, is it light or dark? You have black or white arrows, thin, thick, whatever you want. If I drag this down and I play it, the arrow will appear and there's motion. As you see something happening. I'll remove this one and I'll use a black one. There's a better example for this type of background. So I'll use a more narrow one and I'll let it appear. Also, here goes, if you double click of your click in the preview window, you can resize it by using the corners, and you can rotate it with the green dot to point out what you want to point out. Let's say that you want to emphasize that car that is driving there, then maybe it should be a little smaller, and I want to point it right down there. I'll drag the element to there, and if I play that, see what happens. There it is. So playing around with the elements can be fun. It can give an extra element to your video, make it funny or make it something to learn from. Different shapes, hand drawn things. Oh, let's do another one. I have the Milky Way here. This shows a little bit better. But the movement in the elements is nice to see. And actually, it's a separate video clip that you place on top of the other tracks. It's not just like text. Yeah, the text is also a sort of video clip. But everything around the thing that you see is transparent. It's a see-through video that only shows you what you need to see. If there's somebody's birthday or a wedding and you want to make a nice video about that, this makes it extra. So on top of the video, you can make it more like a celebration. And you see, there's not much motion in that. The motion is in the start of the element when it folds out. So that were the elements in Filmora.